This video will discuss how doctors can tell the difference between chlamydia and vaginal yeast infection. My name is Dr. Slava Fuzayloff. I'm a practicing STD doctor at STDcenterNY, located in Midtown Manhattan, New York City. I know you have limited time and I value your time. Let's proceed. I have to mention in the beginning that the best and the only definitive way to diagnose both chlamydia and vaginal yeast infection is through testing. This video is for people waiting to be tested or waiting for the test to come back so they can make a correct assumption based on signs and symptoms. So how doctors differentiate between chlamydia and vaginal yeast infection during the visit? We usually consider two things when differentiating between chlamydia and vaginal yeast infection: a visual exam and a history of the symptoms. We will go into more details about each part later, but for now, I can briefly say that visual exam is when we look at the vaginal area and check that area for redness and swelling and assess the discharge at the same time. History of the symptoms is when we go over the causes of the symptoms, how soon they showed up, and how they are changing over time. Before the test results are available, 60% of the preliminary diagnosis come from the visual exam, and 40% come from the history. Let's talk about the history of the symptoms first. As I mentioned earlier, 40% of the diagnosis come from the history. History of the symptoms consists of three parts: what caused symptoms, how soon did it take for symptom to appear, and how are symptoms evolving or changing over time. We will talk about each part of history in detail now. Let's go over the possible causes for both conditions first. Both conditions can be caused by sexual activity. Chlamydia typically occurs only with unprotected contact. It can be receiving oral or genital to genital contact. Any infected secretion, sperm, vaginal fluid, saliva should come into contact with mucosa of the mouth, of the throat, vagina, urethra, or rectum for the chlamydia infection to occur. Unlike chlamydia, yeast infection can be induced by anything that changes the vaginal pH. It can be caused by sexual contact or other non-sexual causes. When yeast infection is caused by sexual contact, it can be induced by either protected or unprotected contact, unlike chlamydia, which is caused by unprotected sex only. During the visit, we usually briefly go over the non-sexual causes of yeast infection, such as recent antibiotic use, the recent start of birth control pills with a high estrogen level, ask about diabetes, pregnancy. In addition, most of the time, females with yeast infection remember having at least one yeast infection episode, since some females are more prone to yeast infection than others. The next part of the history is how soon after sexual contact symptoms appeared. This is a major differentiating factor. The incubation period is shorter for yeast infection. Yeast infection symptoms appear within a day or two of sexual activity. Chlamydia symptoms take 2 to 3 weeks to show up. The next and last part of the history I want to mention is how symptoms change over time. We will not talk about each symptoms here. We will talk about them later, but how those symptoms are progressing over time. Let's start with vaginal yeast infection. Symptoms begin as an itch and redness of the vaginal opening. If left untreated, the itch and redness might progress, causing swelling of the vulva and vagina opening, as well as abundant white discharge. Unlike yeast infection, chlamydia causes minimal itching and discharge of the vaginal area. The main symptoms of chlamydia is urinary symptoms of burning, increased urgency, and frequency of urination. Chlamydia infection, if left untreated, can lead to painful intercourse, bleeding with sexual activity and between periods, or even pelvic inflammatory disease, PID, which can cause lower abdominal pain and infertility. We just finished the history comparison for both conditions. Now let's compare the visual exam. Again, 60% of the preliminary diagnosis come from the visual exam of the vagina and discharge. Before proceeding to the most important part of this video, I will take a moment asking you for a favor to support our channel by liking this video or subscribing to our channel. So let's return to our topic and compare visual exam for two conditions, vaginal yeast infection and chlamydia. The visual exam consists of two parts, vaginal exam and a discharge evaluation. Let's discuss each part separately and in more details. Let's talk about the discharge differences for the two conditions first. Let's start with chlamydia this time. Chlamydia discharge is minimal and very little is produced. And if it is produced, it's very thin or watery, and the color is either white or colorless. Yeast infection discharge is abundant and white in color. It's very thick with a cottage cheese texture. Most of the time, the discharge is not smelly. To summarize, the most critical part of the discharge for two conditions. Chlamydia discharge is minimal, thin, colorless, or white. Yeast infection discharge is an abundant, thick, white color with a cottage cheese texture. The last part I want to mention in this video is a visual exam of the vagina for both conditions. Let's start with yeast infection. Yeast infection is defined as vaginitis. It's a fungal overgrowth that causes inflammation of the outer portion of the vagina. That is the reason we see redness and swelling of the vulva and vagina opening, as well as more abundant discharge with yeast infection. Chlamydia infection affects deeper part of the vaginal or the beginning of the uterus called cervix. Therefore, no visible redness and swelling are noticed from the outside, or it's very minimal. That brings us to the end of the video. If you learned something and it was helpful, please remember to give this video the thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. And if you want to share your experience in the comment section to help others, please do so. Thanks for watching, and until next time.